अस्सलाम वालेकुम बेटे, वी आर नाउ गोइंग टू स्टडी द क्रेब साइकिल एंड बिफोर दैट आई विल रिक्वेस्ट यू टू प्लीज ओपन योर लिपन कॉर्ड बायोकेमिस्ट्री बुक एंड पेज नंबर 892 एंड चैप्टर 8 एंड फिगर नंबर 2, 8.2 फिगर. इट्स बेसिकली द इंटीग्रेटेड ऑल द मेटाबॉलिक पाथवेज and it will be easy for you when you will have this picture in front of you. Now, what is the tricarboxyl cycle? Tricarboxyl acid cycle. You can call it TCA cycle. And it's also called the Krebs cycle or the citric acid cycle. And it's a much role in the metabolism. It is basically the final pathway where the oxidated metabolism of carbohydrates, amino acids, and fatty acids converge their carbon skeleton being converted to carbon dioxide. Basically, our diet is composed of the main carbohydrates and then the proteins and then the fat. And all of this will converge into the pathway which is the acetyl-CoA. Or as we know that when we are taking the glucose as a diet, as in the well-fed state, when we have eaten a lot of carbohydrates, there is a galactose, fructose, glucose, and they will convert to the glucose 1-phosphate. When in the glycolysis we have studied that glucose 1-phosphate will convert to the glucose 6-phosphate. And glucose 6-phosphate to the fructose 6-phosphate. Fructose 6-phosphate will convert into the fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. And fructose 1,6-bisphosphate will convert to the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Now it is the split of the basically 6 carbon molecule of the glucose into the 1 glyceraldehyde and there is the dihydroxyacetone phosphate. And dihydroxyacetone phosphate will automatically will convert into the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. And now the parallel reaction will occur from the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate to the 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate, and it will be double reaction because this is molecule of the 3 carbon molecule. Then the 1,3 bisphosphate glycerate to the 3 phosphoglycerate, 3 phosphoglycerate to the 2 phosphoglycerate, 2 phosphoglycerate to the phosphoenol pyruvate, and now the phosphoenol pyruvate will convert into the pyruvate and pyruvate to the acetyl-CoA. This was the pathway if we have eaten the carbohydrate rich diet. But what will happen to the fat? Fat in the form of the fatty acetyl-CoA, it will automatically with the oxygen beta oxidation, it will come to the acetyl-CoA, and same the will occur with the protein diet. Protein, amino acids, proline, histidine, arginine, they will convert to the glutamate. Glutamate will convert into the one of the intermediates of the TCA cycle. Now, intermediates of the TCA cycle, it is acetyl-CoA. From acetyl-CoA, it is the citrate. From citrate, it is the isocitrate. From isocitrate, it will convert into the alpha-ketoglutarate. and it is the intermediate of the TCA cycle in which there is entry of the glutamate protein diet and then alpha ketoglutarate to the succinyl CoA. Succinyl CoA, it is the intermediate of the TCA cycle in which from fatty acetyl CoA will convert into the, there will be expulsion of the acetyl CoA, propionyl coenzyme A and propionyl coenzyme A will convert into the methyl malonyl coenzyme A. Propionyl coenzyme A will convert into the methyl malonyl coenzyme A and methyl malonyl coenzyme A will convert to the succinyl coenzyme A, which is one of the intermediate of the TCA cycle. Now, for remembering the intermediates of the TCA cycle, you will remember can I keep selling soap? Soap in the lockdown condition, it's very important. Soap for money officer. Can I keep selling soap for money officer? These are the abbreviations of the intermediates of the TCA cycle. Can citrate, acetyl CoA will convert to the citrate. I, isocitrate. Can I, isocitrate will convert into the alpha ketoglutarate. Keep, succinyl CoA, soap, selling, succinyl CoA will be converted to the succinate, soap, a soap to the succinate to the fumarate, for fumarate to the malate, money, and malate will be oxaloase, which is the officer. Can I keep selling soap for money officer? These are the intermediates of the TCA cycle. And here there is the entry of the fat from propionyl coenzyme A, methyl malonyl coenzyme A into the succinyl coenzyme. And from proteins, glutamate will convert into the alpha-ketoglutarate. And the aspartate will convert into the oxaloacetate. This oxidation provides energy for the production of the majority of the ATP in most animals, including humans. Without oxidation process, the formation of the ATP is very low. In the glycolysis, in the anaerobic glycolysis, there was a net production of only 2 ATP molecules because we have invested 2 in ATP molecules and we earned 4 ATP molecules. It means there is a net production of only 2, but when there is oxygen, there is also production of NADH, NADPH, and it will produce 3, there is production of 2 NADPH, reduced form of nicotine adenine dinucleotide phosphate. It will produce 6 ATPs. It means when there is oxidation, reduction, there is the ATP production will enhance. The cycle occurs totally in the mitochondria as the electron transport chain. The site for the TCA cycle is the mitochondria, and mean that is the close proximity directions of the lectin transport chain, which is also in the mitochondria, in which oxidize the reduced coenzyme produced by the cycle. During this cycle, NADH, FADH are produced, and these are the reduced form. They can donate electron and proton. They will go into the electron transport chain, and here there will be the transfer of the proton and the transport of the proton and the transfer of the electrons. We have studied this. Then the TCA cycle. It is aerobic. It is anaerobic pathway because oxygen is required as the final electron acceptor. Most of the body's catabolic pathway converge on the TCA cycle. You can see that the catabolic pathway and anabolic pathway, catabolic degradative pathway, they converge by the production of the ATPs. They converge on the ATPase cycle. Glycolysis convert to the ATPase cycle. Beta oxidation of the and the proteins, these are all convert to the TCA cycle. And from TCA cycle, they will go to the urea formation, and hexose monophosphate shunt will also come into the TCA cycle. Reactions such as the catabolism of some amino acids generate intermediates of the cycle and are called anaplerotic reactions. Anaplerotic reactions, these are basically reactions which these are for the refilling of the intermediates of the CTA, TCA cycles. For example, when it is these are intermediates are extracted out for biosynthesis of other products, and we have seen beta oxidation of fatty acids to succinyl-CoA. Succinyl-CoA, it is the intermediate of the TCA cycle. Please see on the figure 8.2 chart. Succinyl-CoA and the beta oxidation of the fatty acid as fatty acyl-CoA is going to the propionyl coenzyme A to the methyl malonyl coenzyme A, and it will enter into the succinyl-CoA. In this way, it is providing the intermediate. Fat is providing the intermediate to the TCA cycle. And then the amino acids. Amino acids, protein, histidine, arginine will convert into the glutamate, and glutamate will convert into the alpha-ketoglutarate. In this way, alpha-ketoglutarate will be provided by the amino acids. Pyruvate to oxaloacetate. Pyruvate is in the glycolysis reaction. You can see that pyruvate is going to convert into the oxaloacetate, which will again convert into the phosphoenol pyruvate, and it is used for the formation of the new carbohydrates, gluconeogenesis. And the glutamate to the alpha keto glutarate. The citric acid cycle also supplies the intermediates for a number of important synthetic reactions. For example, the cycle functions in the formation of glucose from the carbon skeleton of some amino acids, and is a provides building blocks for the synthesis of the amino acids and heme. As amino acids, you can see that proline, histidine, arginine will convert into the glutamate. Glutamate will convert into the alpha-ketoglutarate, which is intermediate of the TCA cycle. And the same way, the heme. Heme is synthesized in the mitochondria and cytosol, but first step, which is in the mitochondria, there is the condensation of the succinyl-CoA एंड ग्लाइसिन, सक्सिन एल्को ए एंड ग्लाइसिन, एंड इन दिस वे इट टेकिंग पार्ट, द टीसीए साइकिल इज टेकिंग पार्ट इन द हीम सिंथेसिस, बिकॉज सक्सिन एल्को, इट विल टेक सक्सिन एल्को ए फ्रॉम द, विच इज द इंटरमीडिएट ऑफ द टीसीए साइकिल फॉर द सिंथेसिस ऑफ द हीम. Therefore, this cycle should not be viewed as a closed circle. In this way, you can see it is not just a closed circle, but instead as a traffic circle with compounds entering and leaving as required. You can see in TCA cycle, from oxaloacetate, it can go to the phosphoenyl pyruvate. It can leave and can be used in the gluconeogenesis. And then the fumarate, from fumarate, it can leave, it will fumarate, it is also one of the intermediate of the TCA cycle. And from fumarate to the arginosuccinate will convert into the fumarate, and fumarate will go into the urea cycle. And fumarate will go into the malate, malate will be oxaloacetate. And the same, the alpha ketoglutarate will come from the glutamate. And the succinyl go from the fatty acetyl co A. These are all the which are entering or leaving the TCA cycle. The site is the mitochondria. It is occurs in the mitochondrial matrix. Electron transport chain where it occurs in the inner membrane, but the TCA cycle in the mitochondrial matrix. It is the series of biochemical reaction in which the acetyl portion of the acetyl-CoA is acetyl-CoA. Acetyl portion will oxidize to carbon dioxide, and the reduced coenzyme FADH2 and NADH plus H1 free proton. These will be produced, and there's the both FADH2 and NAD, these are in the reduced form. They will donate their electrons in the electron transport chain, and the proton transfer of the proton, and with the transfer of the protons in the matrix, and then again, outside the membrane, and again it will, they will generate the, used in the generation of the ATP. FADH will generate two ATPs, and NADH will produce 3 ATP. Some books link that FADH 1.5 and NADH 2.5. Both are correct. The Krebs cycle is what is known as the amphibolic. It is the amphibolic in that it is both catabolic. Catabolic means the breakdown of molecules, and anabolic, build up of molecules, breakdown of molecule. Citrate is breaking down to the isocitrate, isocitrate to alpha ketoglutarate, and when there is a building block, they can take the carbon and they will go in the form, they will use in the formation of the amino acids. And the heme synthesis had we studied that succinyl-CoA will unite with the glycine in the first step of the heme synthesis. And the carbon skeleton of the, this used for the formation of the glucose, of the amino acids will be used for the formation of the carbohydrate or glucose. It is a series of chemical reactions used by all aerobic organisms to generate energy through the oxidation of acetate derived from carbohydrates, fats and proteins into the carbon dioxide. So again, repetition from carbohydrates, the process of glycolysis, pyruvate into acetyl-CoA. From the fat, the fatty acetyl-CoA will convert into the acetyl-CoA. And from the protein, the glutamate will convert into the alpha-ketoglutarate, and aspartate into the amino acid will convert into the oxaloacetate. And acetyl-CoA will enter, it is the start of the TCA cycle, while the alpha ketoglutarate is one of the intermediate, and oxaloacetate is also one of the intermediate of the GCA cycle. Thank you very much. Inshallah, tomorrow we will start from the next. Thank you very much.